Hello everyone, myself Apurva Pindbaze, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering, would like to introduce you to the topic friction, which is a part of the first year mechanical engineering subject, engineering mechanics. By the end of this video, learners will be able to explain the concept of friction, will be able to illustrate laws of friction, and will be able to define angle of friction and angle of repose. Friction force is developed whenever there is a motion or tendency of motion of one body with respect to the other body, involving rubbing of the surfaces of contact. We will understand the concept of friction and also present the laws of friction. Friction is of two types, dry friction and fluid friction. Dry friction is also known as Coulomb friction, which involves friction due to rubbing of rigid bodies. For example, a block tending to move on a table or a wheel rolling on the ground. Fluid friction is developed between layers of fluids as they move with different velocities inside a pipe, bodies moving over lubricated surface, etc. Our study would be limited to dry friction. Frictional force is generated whenever a body moves or tends to move over another surface. This is best illustrated by the following example. Consider a block of weight W resting on a rough surface. Let the normal reaction be L. The block is in equilibrium under the action of two forces. Here we are having the block, which is having its weight W resting on a surface which is rough in nature. And as we know, for every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So there has been normal reaction offered by the surface to the block. Now, if an attempt is made to disturb the equilibrium by applying a force P, as shown in this figure. Here we can see, apart from these two, an additional force P is being acted upon on the body. The rough surface generates a frictional force F. The rough surface generates a frictional force F to maintain the equilibrium. The force F is equal to force P, and the block is maintained in the equilibrium state. If P is now increased, what will happen? If P is increased, frictional force F also increases. In the graph, we can see as the P increases, friction force also tends to increase up to certain limit. Up to this point, the body will be in the state of equilibrium, means it will be at the rest or it will be at the state of uniform motion up till this portion. As P increases, F is also going to increase. Once this value of X exceeds the value of P, then you can see the nature of the graph. It will remain as a horizontal line. This is what after the body is in motion. The terminologies we are going to see afterwards. So this limiting friction, here we are going to call it as F max. F max will be called as what? Limiting friction. If P exceeds F max, the body would be set into motion and the block is said to be in a dynamic state. Static means in the position of rest and dynamic means it is in motion. In dynamic state, the same surface develops a lower friction force known as kinetic frictional force. Up till this, we can say it is static position and then it is in motion. So it is dynamic. So we are saying what? Fk will be always less than this limiting friction force. Friction force generated is generally due to presence of hills and valleys. Whenever we consider any surface, let us say this is the box that is resting on the table. So when we zoom, there will be some irregularities on the surface of the ground as well as the block. So this will cause the friction in between the two surfaces which are in contact. So these hills and valleys on the surface and smaller extent due to molecular attraction, this can be seen in a microscopic view. So when body is in static condition, there is a greater interlocking between the hills and the valleys of two surfaces. As the body becomes dynamic, means body comes into motion, the interlocking reduces, resulting in lowering the friction force to a new value Fk. So this is clear to us. Now moving to the coefficient of friction. It has been experimentally found that the ratio of limiting frictional force F max and the normal reaction N is constant, and this constant is referred to the coefficient of static friction, which is denoted by mu s. Coefficient of friction is defined as ratio of limiting friction and normal reaction. When it is limiting friction, mu will be called as mu s, that is coefficient of static friction. So mu s will be equal to what? Limiting friction F max upon normal reaction S. And when body is in motion, so coefficient of kinetic friction, their force is what? Kinetic force divided by M. So this is the difference between coefficient of static friction and coefficient of kinetic friction. And naturally, as we have seen from the graph, mu S is always going to be greater than mu k, because F max will always be the maximum force or limiting force, and Fk is going to be what? Always less than the limiting frictional force. That's why static coefficient of friction is always going to be greater than kinetic coefficient of friction. This is the point which is to be noted. So with the help of this diagram, we are going to understand few things. In first diagram, what we can see, a force P is being applied on the body along the vertical direction and nature is in downward direction. So here there will be no friction. So since the force is in vertical direction, horizontal component of that force is going to be zero. So what is the condition of equilibrium that we are having? Normal reaction will be equal to summation of P and W, and friction force is coming to be zero because there is no other horizontal force. So this force is going to become what? Zero. Now what we are doing, at a particular point we are applying a force P at an angle. The magnitude of force P is such that when you resolve this force into two components, that is Y component and X component, the friction force we are going to consider as equal to the Px, that is X component of the applied force. When also we have seen that what? Mu S is equal to F by N. So here we are saying what? F is, let us say, less than mu s into n. So in this particular case, when you see the condition of equilibrium, what is going to happen? N is going to be equal to what? Py plus w. So this is the equation that we are going to get when we consider summation of forces in y direction. This leads to this equation. Since there is no motion, why? Because it has not yet reached the value of limiting frictional force, F max. So when applied force in X direction is less than the limiting force, there is not going to be any kind of motion. Applied force is not enough to cause the motion. Now what we are doing, we are increasing the number of or magnitude of the force that we have applied. So now let us say this P force is applied. This is resolved component Py and this is resolved component Px. Now limiting friction is equal to force in x direction. So F max is going to be equal to what? Mu s into n. So when we apply the condition of equilibrium, summation Fy is equal to 0, the equation that we will get is n is equal to Py plus W. But what we are saying is Px is equal to the limiting friction force, means motion is impending, body is just about to move. So this is called as what? Impending motion. Body at rest, friction force is 0. Then again body is at rest when force applied in x direction is less than the limiting friction force. Once the applied force is equal to the limiting friction force, motion is about to begin. And next thing is when Px is greater than the limiting friction force, the body will be in the motion. So these are the four states that we have seen. So this was about coefficient of friction. Here it is static, so it is going to be mu s. Here also body is in static position, so it is going to be mu s. But here the body is in motion, so coefficient of friction is going to be kinetic coefficient of friction. Here the equation will be what? Limiting friction force upon normal reaction, and here it will be kinetic force upon the normal reaction. Now there are certain laws regarding to friction. First we will be going through laws of static friction. The friction force always acts in the direction opposite to that in which the body tends to move. Let us say this is the body that we have. This is the applied force P, which is causing motion in positive x direction. Then the friction force will be always opposite to the direction of motion. Or if we consider the reverse case, this is the block, this is the applied force P. So naturally this is going to be the direction of motion. So in this case, friction force is going to act opposite to the direction of motion, that is towards the right hand side. So this is first law of static friction that you have to remember. The friction force always acts in the direction opposite to that in which the body tends to move. Then this we have seen, the magnitude of friction force is equal to the external force. P is the external force and frictional force is the force F. The ratio of limiting friction force and normal reaction is constant, which is known as what? Coefficient of friction. The friction force does not depend upon the area of contact between the two surfaces. Means what? If this is the block and this is the area of contact. So if you consider it to be a 3D thing, so this is going to be the area of contact. Here a certain amount of frictional force is going to take place. In similar manner, if you consider a smaller block with same material, and this is going to be area in this particular case. So what this says is, whether it be a larger area, whether it be a smaller area, friction force does not depend upon the area in contact between two surfaces. The friction force depends upon the roughness of the surface. So which are the two materials that are being in contact, that will decide the amount of frictional force or coefficient of friction. Then there are certain laws regarding to dynamic friction. So first law is again same. The friction force always acts in a direction opposite to the direction of motion of the body. Again, ratio of limiting friction and normal reaction is constant and it is known as coefficient of friction. There we had mu s, here we will be having mu k. F is what? Fk. For moderate speeds, the friction force remains constant, but it decreases slightly with the increase of speed. So this is the point to be remembered. For moderate speeds, the friction force remains constant, but as you go on decreasing increasing speed, the friction coefficient of friction is going to decrease, and we will always know that mu s is going to be greater than mu k. So this is the point to be remembered. Next up we have is angle of friction. Angle of friction is the angle made by the resultant of the limiting frictional force F max and the normal reaction N with the normal reaction. It is the angle made between what? Resultant. Resultant of what? Resultant of limiting friction force F max and normal reaction. This is your F max. This is your normal reaction. This is the resultant of it. So, angle made by the resultant with respect to normal reaction. So, this is the angle which will be called as what? Angle of friction. Now, this we won't be considering. Now, consider this particular diagram. There is a block of weight W under the action of applied force P. Let N be the normal reaction and the block is on the verge of impending motion. The frictional force will be equal to what? Maximum frictional force, that is limiting friction force when it is impending motion. So force is what? F max. Here we can see that normal reaction, limiting friction force and their resultant R. Angle between R and normal reaction, that is your angle of friction phi. So now from the system of forces we have learned that what will be the value of R? Under root F max square plus N square. The right angle triangle is being formed over here. So this is the equation that we get. Similarly, what we can write is tan phi. Now we are considering static things. So let us write tan phi s. Tan is what? Opposite upon adjacent. This is your phi. Opposite is what? F max. And what is adjacent? N. So tan phi s is equal to F max upon s. Or in other word, we can say that tan phi s is nothing but equal to what? In previous slide we have seen F max upon N is nothing but what? Coefficient of static friction. So therefore tan phi will be equal to mu s, or we can say phi s will be equal to tan inverse of mu s. So this is the thing that you have to remember: angle of friction and the relation of that with respect to coefficient of friction. Angle of friction is the angle between the resultant of normal reaction and limiting friction force and normal reaction. So this is about angle of friction. Next up we have is what? Angle of repose. Angle of repose is defined as the minimum angle of inclination of a plane with the horizontal for which a body kept on it will just slide down on its own weight without any application of external force. This is the body that we are having. This is your block. It is having certain weight. Weight is what? Mass into gravitational acceleration, which is acting in vertically downward direction. So right now along the direction of motion we are going to have our x and y axis. So when we consider this force, this is making certain angle with x y axis. So we have to resolve this force along x axis and along y axis. When this is going to be theta, when you calculate with the help of trigonometry, this is also going to be equal to theta. Now let us say terminology, angle of repose is represented by alphabet or symbol alpha. So theta will be equal to alpha when? Now body is about to lose its condition of equilibrium. First of all, let us say component in x direction of it is mg sine theta. This is theta, so along this direction it is going to be what? Opposite. So mg sine theta, and this is adjacent, so along y-axis we have mg cos theta. Direction of motion is in downward direction, so frictional force will be acting opposite to it, and normal reaction is exactly in the direction of or perpendicular to the surface. So we have W, X component of that weight, Y component of that weight, frictional force opposite to the direction of motion, body is about to slide down due to its self weight at that particular position, theta is equal to alpha, and normal reaction, which is perpendicular to the surface of contact. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to apply the conditions of equilibrium. What are the conditions of equilibrium that we are aware of? Summation of forces along x direction should be equal to 0, and summation of forces along y direction should be equal to 0. So first of all, we will consider this. This is our positive sign and this is our positive notification that we are going to use. So when we write summation of forces along x direction is equal to 0, what all are the forces in x direction? Positive x direction, there is a frictional force. That, let us say, this is limiting frictional force, body is about to move, so this will be F max. And opposite to this is your mg sine theta, but here theta is equal to alpha, minus W sine alpha. This should be equal to 0. But what is F max? It is mu s into normal reaction minus W sine alpha is equal to 0. So this is the equation that we have. Now when we apply summation Fy is equal to 0, the forces in positive y direction are only n forces there, and other force that is in y direction is what? Minus W cos alpha is equal to 0. So now from here we can say n is equal to W cos alpha. So here at the place of n, can we substitute this value? So this equation becomes what? Mu s into W cos alpha minus W sin alpha is equal to 0. So W we can take it as common and it gets cancelled. So what the equation remains as? Tan alpha is equal to mu. Or we can say alpha is equal to, this is static coefficient of friction, tan inverse of mu s. Also we knew that phi, angle of friction, was also equal to tan inverse of mu s. So from this equation and this equation we can say that phi equal to alpha. So angle of repose is going to be equal to angle of friction. So this is what all about friction and its terminology. In same way, you can relate to this. So this is it with the today's session. I hope you have understood. Thank you very much.